Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in dentistry and more. Topic for today is types of FPD in prosthodontics. So FPD is also known as bridge. So as per definition, FPD is a partial denture that is cemented to natural teeth or roots which furnish the primary support to the processes. So it is being fixed to the natural teeth or roots. So we have various types of fixed partial denture or bridge. There is conventional bridge, cantilever bridge, spring cantilever, fixed partial denture, fixed movable partial denture, fixed removable partial denture or removable bridges, modified fixed removable partial denture, all metal, metal ceramic and all ceramic. So in conventional FPD, they are the most commonly used type of FPD. So the design involves fabrication of a FPD which takes support from abutment on either side of the edentulous space. So the design may vary according to the conditions of the abutment, but the abutment on either side should be able to support the fixed partial denture. So this is the most commonly used conventional FPD. We take support from either side. So that is our conventional FPD. Next we have the cantilever FPD. So we know cantilever bridges. So similarly, cantilever FPD is used when support can be obtained only from one side. Okay, so this is both side, and cantilever get support only from one side of the edentulous space. So these dentures have compromised support because this has support from both side of the pontic, but this is having support only from one side, so there's high chances of dislodgement. So the abutment teeth on the supporting side should be strong enough to withstand the additional torsional forces. So support can be obtained from more than one tooth on the same side of the edentulous spaces. So cantilever FPDs have the advantage because it is sacrificing just one tooth, unlike the conventional where it sacrifices two teeth. But it has got many disadvantages. So the basic advantages are, it is very conservative design, as I said, especially when a single abutment is involved. When secondary abutments are used, parallel preparation can be easily obtained because the abutments are adjacent to one another, because we are taking from only from one side of the tooth, and it is very easy to fabricate. But the main problem with this cantilever FPD, it produces torquing forces on the abutment because there is no balancing forces. It is just torquing forces, and it cannot be used to restore a long span edentulous spaces. Only one tooth replacement will be done by this cantilever, and minor design error can affect the abutments in a large scale. So it is very technique sensitive one. Now we have spring cantilever FPD. So this is a special cantilever bridge exclusively designed for the replacing maxillary incisors, but these dentures can support only a single pontic. So if one central incisor is missing, we can go for spring cantilever FPD. And support is obtained from posterior abutments, usually a single molar or a pair of splinted premolars. The main advantage is it can be used for diastema cases. Metal crown retainers that requires minimal tooth preparation can be used in posterior tooth to replace missing incisors. But the problem with spring cantilever FPD, the connector bar, this connector bar may interfere with speech and mastication, and deformation of this connector bar may produce coronal displacement of the pontic, and there may be food entrapment under the connector bar, which may lead to tissue hyperplasia on the palate. So that was about our spring cantilever FPD. Now we have fixed partial denture. So the term denotes fixed partial dentures with rigid connectors. So this is having rigid connectors. So the design of these dentures is more conventional. Since the connectors are rigid, there can be no movement between the connected components, and these are the most commonly used fixed partial denture designs. So there will be rigid connectors between these. The main advantages of fixed FPD are it is very easy to fabricate, it is economical, it is strong, easy to maintain, and it has good retention and strength. It helps to splint the mobile abutment, and it can also be used for long bridges along with periodontally weak abutments. But what are the problems with this fixed FPD? Since the connectors are rigid, there will be unwanted stress and lever forces are directly transferred to the abutment, which produces considerable damage. And it also requires excessive tooth preparation to achieve a single path of placement. And it is difficult to cement on multiple abutments, and it is contraindicated for pyre abutment. Now we have fixed movable partial denture. So it is defined as a fixed partial denture which is having one or more non-rigid connectors. Okay, this is having non-rigid connectors. Fixed FPD or fixed partial denture is having rigid connectors, and this is having non-rigid because it is movable partial denture. So here a non-rigid connector is used or fabricated to connect the components of the fixed partial denture. And commonly used non-rigid connectors include the TMC, that is tenon mortise connectors, loop connectors or split pontic connectors, and cross pin and wing connectors. So the advantages of this movable partial denture, they act like stress breakers while transmitting unwanted leverage forces. That was fixed partial denture. And the abutment is pressurized only during the occlusal loading, and so it improves the health of the abutment. And the tooth preparation need not be parallel to one another. Each abutment tooth can be prepared independently according to its requirement. And it also allows minor movements between the components because it is non-rigid connector between the teeth. So the problem with fixed movable partial denture, it's the design is very complex. Prefabricated connector components are very expensive. It is difficult to maintain, and these mobile parts tend to wear out under constant usage, and it cannot be used for long span bridges, and there will be a complicated lab procedures, and the temporization also is difficult with fixed mobile partial denture. Now we have fixed removable partial denture or removable bridges. Okay, this is very confusing. This is fixed movable partial denture. This is fixed removable partial denture. This is also known as removable bridges. So one of the major disadvantages of the long span FPD denture is that if one abutment fails, that is fixed partial denture I'm talking about, the main disadvantage is that if one abutment fails, the entire process has to be sacrificed. To overcome this disadvantage, fixed removable bridges were introduced. So these dentures cannot be removed by the patient but can be easily removed by the dentist. So this is removable one. This is mobile because of this non-rigid connector. This is removable with the help of a dentist. Okay, so this is to avoid the problem with the long span dentures where one abutment fails, the entire processes will be lost. So in such cases we can use this fixed removable partial denture. Whereas the next one, so you can see the picture here, the removable bridges. Next we have the modified fixed removable partial denture. So that is a modification of this one. So they were developed by Andrew, hence they are also known as Andrew's bridge system. Andrew's bridge. This is modified fixed removable partial denture. So these dentures are indicated for edentulous ridges with severe vertical deficit. So the processes consists of a fixed component and a removable component. So it is having a fixed component and also a removable component. So you can see here, there is a fixed component and there is a removable component. Now we have the common all metal fixed partial denture or FPD. These dentures are fabricated using just metal, and they are indicated for replacing maxillary and mandibular posterior teeth. Because of this aesthetic, will not be a problem for the posterior teeth. and they have the maximum strength and durability because the masticatory forces are mainly on the posterior teeth. Now we have the metal ceramic FPD. So in metal ceramic FPD, what happens is the core of the process is made up of metal and the external surface is fabricated using ceramic. So this metal is bonded to the ceramic chemically, mechanically and anechoically. So metal ceramic FPDs can be of two types. In the first type, The first type, the metal is surrounded by porcelain on all the surfaces. In the second type, the lingual and occlusal surface is formed by metal, whereas the labial and gingival surface is alone formed by the porcelain. So these restorations are termed as porcelain phasing or porcelain veneer. Porcelain phasing. So that is where the labial and gingival surfaces formed by porcelain rest by the, that is the lingual and occlusal by metal. In the first type, the metal is surrounded by porcelain on all surfaces. Porcelain surrounding all surfaces. Okay, so that is metal ceramic. Now we have, before that, the advantages of this FPD, that is metal ceramic FPD, if you are using all porcelain, that is, it is aesthetically pleasing, it is stronger metal substructure is there, so it has got good force withstanding power. But the main problem is tooth preparation need to be in more depth, that is around 1.5 2 mm preparation is there for metal ceramic or with metal base. So it is more expensive and there can be brittle fractures can occur due to the failure at the metal ceramic junction. So for more better aesthetics, the facial margin of an anterior restoration is often placed subgingivally. This increases the potential of gingival destruction. This is comes with metal ceramic FPD. Now we have the all ceramic FPD. In all ceramic FPD, the dentures are fabricated using only ceramic, there is no metal. All ceramic are less fracture resistant, hence they do not render as a good retainers. However, aluminium reinforced porcelain have sufficient strength to be used as a good retainers. So the best property of all ceramic is the superior aesthetics and excellent translucency. It will be almost like a natural tooth. And it requires just light preparation because there is no metal in, so around 1 mm preparation would be fine. So the appearance can be influenced and modified by the selecting different colors of the luting agent. So we need to be cautious about the luting agent. But the disadvantage is reduced strength due to the lack of reinforcement with metal. The main advantage is the aesthetic properties, but disadvantage is there is no metal, so the strength is reduced, but it is mainly used in anteriors. And it is very difficult to obtain a well-finished margin because the ceramic edges tend to chip easily. And these crowns cannot be used on extensively damaged teeth because they cannot support this restoration. And since these porcelain are brittle in nature, large connectors have to be used, which usually tend to impingement of the interdental papillae. This increases the potential for periodontal disease and there will be wearing of opposite natural teeth. So after all ceramic, there are materials like all acrylic FPD is also there, but it is very rare nowadays. So it is only indicated for long-term, temporary or interim processes. It can be used for making fixed periodontal splints. It has got very poor wear resistance, but it is easy to fabricate and adjust. And also there is veneers. Veneers are there. Veneer, we know, which is just a layer of restoration placed over the labial surface of tooth. They are primarily used as a aesthetic adjunct to the discolored or fractured teeth. It is mainly for aesthetics, people who are more concerned about their aesthetics, public speakers, people in film industry, they commonly use this veneers because just a layer of labial surface is replaced. So types of veneers, it can be ceramic veneer or acrylic veneer is there. So ceramic veneer is the most ideal veneering material because of its good aesthetics. So mostly all ceramic restorations will be used in veneering. Also acrylic also is there. There is another option. Acrylic tooth colored material can be used with metallic restoration as a veneer, but they are not considered as a permanent material due to the poor wear resistance. We have another type of bridges too, that is short span bridges. So these are simple FPDs which replaces one or two teeth, and the teeth on either side are ideal abutments. So these dentures are considered ideal because they have minimal talking forces. For example, first molar replacement, that is a short span bridges. Also we have long span bridges. So in long span bridges, which denotes a condition where two or more teeth have to be replaced and more than one abutment has to be taken for the support on either side. So long span bridges have the potential for producing more torquing forces on the bridge and the weaker abutment. So that is a long span bridge. And lastly, we have two more types, that is one is fiber reinforced composite resin bridge and the next one is resin bonded FPDs. So this was about the types of FPD. So we had various types, that is conventional FPDs, then the cantilever FPDs, then we have the removable FPD, that is a fixed modified fixed removable partial dangers and fixed removable partial dangers. Then we had fixed partial dentures, then all metal ceramic, metal infused or all ceramic, then we have the short span bridges, long span bridges. So it is commonly asked a short essay, or sometimes just the cantilever FPD will be asked as a short note, but in all the cases always try to draw pictures to express the ideas. Hope you understood the concept of types of FPD and the various types and its differences. So I'll come up with a new topic in dentistry and more. Thank you.